Good morning everyone. So today I want to show you the combiner box for the two classics that are in the power shed. So what we've done is our PV wire, right up there where it comes over the roof, instead of poking a hole in the roof, we've used a piece of inch and a half non-metallic liquid tight as a chase to protect the wires. This is actually, you know, PV wire, 1000 volt PV wire. So we have six strings coming down off the roof, or 12 wires. So you'll see that we have three fuse holders here and three here, each having their own bus bar, and then each having its own negative bus bar here as well. So we have four, you know, two sets of positive, two sets of negatives going back to the power shed through a conduit and coming up in the power shed. We set this up this way because as we start charging the 600 volt, as we start testing the 600 volt products, we can come in here and basically pull wires out and reconfigure and get 600 volts, you know, into the building with two strings. So we can do two separate strings into the building at 600 volts each, or we can do one string at 600 volts, depending on which controller we're testing. These are using fuses, 15 amp, 1000 volt fuses, what we have, and using the strain release up in the bottom. I like to do it this way. I get asked a lot, can you come in the top? And while you could punch holes in the top and put these strain reliefs up in there, and in theory they'd be waterproof, I'm not a big fan because it's just one more way for water to get in. I like making that drip loop, you know, like that. That way if any water does chase down, it drips off, it doesn't, you know, it doesn't get in anything. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna put the cover down on this before we get too much rain, and show you what it looks like closed up. We're gonna actually see if we can set you somewhere. Hold on a second. Okay, sorry about that. Pretty hard to run a screwdriver, a screw, and a camera all in one motion. So anyways, pretty neat, clean install when it's done. It's easy access. This is about 15, 16, maybe even closer to 20 feet in the air. But we have a shed roof, lean-to roof that we can stand on, real easy access. And like I say, it comes out through the wall here. Basically goes down the side of the building, underground, and over to that power shed. You can just see on the side of the power shed right there, there's a 12 by 12 PVC box. All the wiring comes in there and goes to the appropriate places in the power shed. So that's pretty much it for how we get the PV from the roof into the power shed. We'll show you the rest of the power shed in another video. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.